If you're wondering how to pass CompTIA's Server Plus exam, you are in the right place. Hey everyone, I'm Kelsey from CompTIA, and today we are giving you the inside scoop into all things Server Plus SK0-005. Okay, before we get into it, do us a favor and do yourself a favor. Like this video and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell for notifications when we are live or when we're premiering a new video. I'm joined by the brains of the operation, Randall and James. Randall, we'll start with you. Tell everyone who you are and what would you say you do here?
Hi, I'm Randall. I am the product manager for Server Plus and for our infrastructure certifications. And what this means is I kind of take the industry pulse of where our certifications have come from, where they're going, what's important about them. I come from the exam development side of the house here, so I have a really good knowledge of what it means for these certifications to be refreshed. So as we talk about this upcoming new Server Plus exam, I will be able to answer any of your questions and give you some insight onto why we change it and what's new.
Hi folks, I'm James Stanger. I'm the Chief Technology Evangelist for CompTIA. My job is to work with IT professionals, hiring managers around the world to kind of keep an idea of the trends that are going on and also about how people are learning about things such as servers, Server Plus, et cetera. So happy to be here.
Awesome. Okay, let's get to why everyone is here. How to pass Server Plus. And it's probably against the rules for us to give you like a full step-by-step guide as to how to pass one of these exams, but we are going to get pretty darn close today. So the first tip that I'll tell you is the objectives are your friend. James, can you tell us why this is a little bit of a secret weapon to get you started?
You know, the great thing about the objectives is that they were created by working IT professionals. That's their job. Sorry.
It's okay.
I have no idea what that, sorry.
Gotta love a live stream.
All right, sorry, man. I get lots of phone calls. The great thing about the objectives, folks, is that it's their job to capture the thoughts and the job roles of thousands of working subject matter experts. These aren't people who theoretically talk about stuff in academic institutions. These aren't people who just think about stuff. They're actually working every day. I was talking to a guy at Microsoft one time, not too long ago here, just a few months ago. And I said, what is it, you know, when it comes to server administration or the data center, what is it, what are the essential skills there? And he said, well, basically, James, your entire product stack is really important to getting that background knowledge. But then he picked out Server Plus as being a very important part. And it is those objectives because they distill what's important and that allows you to focus on what's important and to ignore what's not important. So it really helps direct your training.
That's great. Okay, so let's take a look at what this new exam looks like and compare it to the old exam. We'll take a look here with some of our prerequisites and then also kind of looking at the domains and where it actually lands. So hands-on experience is, of course, one of the best things. You're not necessarily going to start your IT career and then all of a sudden, you know, get your Server Plus exam or start studying for Server Plus. You really do need that hands-on experience. We're recommending about 2 years of hands-on experience working in a server environment and also the CompTIA A Plus certification or equivalent knowledge. So James and Randall, let's leave these ones up real quick so you can help us compare, because obviously there's seven domains for the CompTIA Server Plus 004, and then there's only four domains. So how does that work? And you know, kind of distill down that information for us here.
Yeah, Kelsey, that's a great question. What we did with the 005 exam domains is went to these industry experts, went to the subject matter experts, talked to our partners who are actually using the certification, you know, kind of in the wild, so to speak, and asked them what's important, what really needs to be emphasized. And what we found out were the four domains that you see on the screen here, really highlighting the kind of bread and butter of what's done. you're going to be in a server room. You're going to be working with servers, racking and cabling. And so that's hardware installation and management. You know, how do you make sure that these things work and run and that can have a lot of good uptime? How do you administer them? How do you, you know, install OSs? Security and disaster recovery becoming more and more omnipresent and important. And then troubleshooting. Something is going to go wrong and you're going to have to troubleshoot it. I'll let James go a little bit more in depth on some of these. I did want to mention really quickly, though, that Server Plus is a great place for individuals who have their A+, maybe have a year or two of experience, and they're thinking, what's the right direction for me? And it's not, you know, going and already having kind of the networking experience you might have with Network Plus, or not wanting to go the cybersecurity route. This provides an alternative from what we've seen.
You know, notice that what's happening with in the server room, as it were, the data center, is a lot of troubleshooting. Notice that troubleshooting, we amplified that more, and that's because the subject matter experts told us to do that. There's been basically, as things have moved to the cloud, et cetera, what we've also seen, though, is there's what you could call a trifecta, right? There's the server room, people will call that on-premise. Then there's the data center. That's the building down the road that houses a lot of computing capability, we'll call it. And then the cloud. So there's your trifecta. And what we're seeing is we need workers who can move up the value chain. What we saw years ago with the help desk, the traditional help desk, was that break fix went away largely, right? But there are more help desk people now than ever before. That help desk job role did not go away. We're seeing the same sort of thing with the data center, is that the job roles aren't necessarily going away, but there's a lot more automation going on, a lot more streamlining. And so that's why you've seen that major change in the domains and in the objectives. But troubleshooting certainly remains at the forefront. And it's probably even more at the forefront than ever before. Uptime's really important.
Yeah, absolutely. So I want to get into a little bit about the jobs themselves, but I do want to pause here because, Randall, we get this question a lot, knowing that you come from the exam dev side. And James, you touched on this a little bit, but can we kind of just walk it back a little bit and talk about why do the exams retire? And why is there a new exam? And how do we get to that exam? I've got 1,000 more questions for you about this, but let's start with those ones right now.
Yeah, so exams retire for a couple of reasons. One, let's think about technology. How quickly does tech change? When's the last time that you had a phone that wasn't new, maybe even that was new, and you thought, wow, this is a little bit outdated. I think I need the newer model of it. It's the same thing we see what's happening with tech. And it had been about 5 years since the Server Plus exam had been refreshed. And in that time, we realized that so many things have changed that we want to provide what are the cutting edge technologies. James will talk about this a little bit. You know, things are going serverless. Does that mean we don't need servers? Things are moving to the cloud. Does that mean servers aren't important anymore? No, servers are the backbone of everything we're doing here. And we really wanted to streamline and emphasize what the technical skills and key concepts are for these individuals working on servers.
Yeah, it's been interesting to see how technology has been, the use of technology is in this area has changed quite a bit with automation, but also with the ways in which data centers, we rely on them for greater performance. And so it's that ability, the skills that are there to improve the performance of server technologies, to improve the performance of data centers, things like that. It's very important that we need a thinking person behind that to make those good decisions, things like that.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, one of my other questions was going to be, you know, why is this exam or this certification important for the job? And you just said it, we need a human behind it. As much as automation is taking over for something like this, like Randall, you said, this is the backbone. Okay, so I know that we've talked about the exam objectives. They're really great. You can go and download them and also take a look at the links in the description or even the links up here. So the biggest part about passing an exam, though, is studying. So I want to get to this because we know that there are several ways to learn. I'm very visual and I like to have a pretty defined path that I can follow. I don't know if you guys are the same way, but this Server Plus exam is different. And it's different because drum roll, please. for the first time ever, CompTIA is launching training solutions for the Server Plus exam. And this is going to be your second secret weapon, if you will. Randall, you can go into how you like to study maybe, but maybe just list off a couple of the new options of how to train for Server Plus.
Yeah, that's a great point. You don't just read the objectives and by osmosis suddenly understand, oh, really, this is how I administer an operating system. Wow, that's amazing. Hands-on learning is so important. We suggest that you have hands-on experience and you will have that coming in, but we're going to help you augment it. And we can do that with the training partners that work with CompTIA, with the eBooks that we have and the other resources we have available. We have official CompTIA content for the first time ever for Server Plus, and this is huge. We have the CompTIA branded and the CompTIA put together learning, you know, solution that we haven't had in the past that's been so useful for learners to pass their exams. And I'm going to hand it off to James because he really knows these products. I'd like him to talk about kind of that, the trifecta. I think there might actually be for CertMaster as well.
You bet. We have a learning trifecta ready to go, meaning that we have, for example, with CertMaster, you have three basic products. My fingers in there, right? The first one, CertMaster Learn. That's got the stuff that you read or listen to. In fact, I even shot some videos here a couple of months ago with Server Plus. It was a lot of fun to do, like in Chicago HQ studio, and did that. That's the first. Second, you have CompTIA Labs. And that's where you are dropped into actual live environment. They're not simulations. They're not things that you watch. Simulations have their place, but these are actual live labs that you have to go in and do things, fix things. You could set up affinity or anti-affinity. If you don't know what those things are, don't matter. Doesn't matter. Server Plus will teach you that. But that's the second part, is the hands-on labs that Randall was talking about, how important that is, the practical learning. Third part, test prep. CertMaster practice. So there's the third element. And what's cool about that is if you're a testing anxiety person like me, it's all about testing anxiety for me. This really helps me because now I can learn the material. I can practice the material. I can do that and now learn the environment, the testing environment, so I can get past that anxiety. So that way you've got hands-on and good environmental learning for the exam. It's a fantastic combination.
Yeah, it really is. And the feedback that we get on social or on the products itself, it's really great because people are like, wow, I never really understood it or kind of realized how impactful this could be for my test prep. So I love CertMaster Learn, and we've got a very special announcement for you all. For the first time ever, of course, we've got CertMaster Learn, CompTIA Labs, and CertMaster Practice for these. However, we are also now going to give you a free trial for CertMaster Learn for Server Plus. So that way you can get a little taste, and it'll definitely have you coming back, especially if you see James's face in one of the videos in the CertMaster trial. But we're really excited for you, and definitely take a look at the links in the description and also the links that are here in the video. We will have it there that you can go sign up for your free trial, test it out. I love a free trial. I don't know if everyone's the same way, but I like to know what I'm going to get before I actually make that investment. So I think that that's going to be a really great solution for you all. Okay. I want to, now that we know how to train, and that's a really awesome thing for you all, let's bring it home with the jobs that you can get with Server Plus. We've mentioned a couple of the job titles along the way. This is going to be really helpful for you, especially when you are looking for a job. Type in these titles into ZipRecruiter or another job search and, you know, see what those job descriptions are and see how maybe the Server Plus can align with that and help bolster your resume. So James and Randall, this is obviously your arena. So let's highlight maybe five of those top jobs that you can get with Server Plus.
Yeah, I'll take the couple easy ones off the bat here so James can deal with the more difficult technical ones.
Sure.
Broadly speaking, server administrator, you are going to be administering servers, right? And that's what Server Plus really gets you ready for. But even broader than that, I think systems administrator. Systems administration is something that is very important on the infrastructure side. You know, it's important in cybersecurity as well. But we're really seeing these IT pros who maybe are coming from the help desk tier two, have worked their way up, and are wanting to say, what's that next step? And that next step is some sort of systems administration. And that's what Server Plus is going to give you the skills for, is to be able to administer these servers and systems. You don't learn just how to put a server in a server rack or how to cable something. It's really understanding, as James said earlier, how to troubleshoot and how these systems work together. It's moving from that specific end user endpoint to the kind of the server endpoint. And then it becomes about being part of a larger system. And once you have those skills of systems administration, it really opens the door to those next level positions as well. That's why Server Plus is so important for that sysadmin role. But I'll hand it over, James, to you for a couple of the other ones too.
You bet. You know, you're really, with Server Plus, you're moving on very much on to the next level. You know, we can talk about security if you want. You can't really secure what you don't understand. And one of the things that you can do with the server administration, systems administration, is learn about how all those things work. It's a fantastic next step. There's the data center technician is one job role I think is interesting. In fact, I think we just had an article just published about what changes have happened in the data center. So if you don't know what a data center technician job role is in the first place, that article do a great job of telling you what it is. If you're interested in seeing the changes there, you can check that out. But one of the things that I think is really interesting is as we work with uptime in the industry, we've seen how important uptime is, whether it be getting gasoline on the East Coast of the United States, for example, how uptime is.
Yep.
If you're taking considering all of the movement that we've had in going to virtual desktops and all of the important data that is found in a data center, we need technicians who can kind of move up the value chain. I was just talking to a person over at Northrop Grumman, a large contractor based in the US. And he was saying basically what we need are people who can kind of move up the food chain, as it were, or move up the value chain, so that as certain things have been automated, as much as server installation, there's a lot of automation that's happened in that area, we still need good workers to make really smart decisions between on-premise, between the cloud, and between the data center. And so the data center technician is a really important job role. We're also seeing network administrators learning more and more about servers. There's not just that division between, well, I just do layer three networking stuff versus server stuff. We're seeing basically a combination there. And also there are a lot of roving technicians, you can call them, field service technicians, that need to know how servers work, because they're working in various environments where servers exist, and they can't work in their environment being isolated from that server. They need to know exactly how all of these systems work together.
Yeah, there's really so many skills here and so many opportunities with Server Plus certification.
Oh, yeah. You see a lot of people, you know, they want to stampede into something, right?
Yeah.
But if you, you know, whether it be especially security, and it's like, no, actually, you need to live in that environment for a while. And Server Plus gives you that opportunity. It gives you that the knowledge that you need to live in an environment with all of these different systems.
If we didn't get to your question, or if you are a little bit curious about a couple of the domains, or you want to be able to nerd out about it a little bit, let us know in the comments. And James, Randall, myself, we are all in the comment section helping you all out. If I don't know the answer, which happens a lot, I definitely go to the person that has that right answer. So we'll definitely get back to you. But don't forget to check out all of those links in the description. They're super helpful. You'll find things like, you know, all about the new exam, how to train for it, and what jobs you can get with the all new Server Plus. Don't forget, sign up for your free CertMaster Learn trial for Server Plus. And of course, like this video, show us some love, show James and Randall some love. And thank you so much, everybody, for joining us. And we will see you next time.
Take care, everyone.
Thanks.
Bye.